So in the last video I showed you some of the basics for using rulers and pages. Now let's look at some of the more advanced stuff. There's some interesting features if you weren't using a regular document, like in this case this is a regular text document. If you were to change to a page layout format, so you go to Document over here in the sidebar and you turn off Document Body and it converts it to a layout document. Now if I say View and I say Show Rulers, I not only get a horizontal ruler across the top, but I get a vertical ruler as well. Now you can actually have that vertical ruler in a regular word processing document. If you go to Pages, Preferences, and you go to Rulers here, one of the options you've got is to enable the vertical ruler for documents with body text. In other words, a standard word processing document. So if you wanted to see that vertical ruler, you can do it. Another cool thing that you can do here is you can place the origin at the center of the ruler. So here it goes from 0 to, in this case, like 8.5. Right there. I can change that to say 0. So it's 0 in the middle and it's even in the middle vertically. This is very useful if you're doing a page layout document and you want to use 0 as the center rather than as the sides. Makes it easier to figure out how to center items. You can also use rulers to create guidelines. So you can click and drag from either the horizontal or vertical ruler like that and it creates these guides. You can see them if you go to View Guides, and you've got the ability to hide guides or show guides there. So guides are really useful for snapping because you can snap to them, and then if you create other items they can also snap to those guides very easily. And you can click and adjust them. And rulers are useful in being able to see not only where those guides are, but being able to create them or remove them by just dragging them away like that or pulling them in. You can also see in Preferences here you have the ability to change the units for the rulers. You can not have units at all but use percentage instead. So in this case I still have it centered, so 0 at the middle and 50 at either end, or 0 to 100 at the other end. You can also change the color of those alignment guides if you want a different color. So it brings up the little color palette here and I can change the color from something other than that default yellow.